I just had to tell you a little story. I first ran into Eric in 1965 or 66. He was playing at the Bottom Line Club in New York, and I was too young to get in. And I had a crush on him. And I snuck in with a girlfriend of mine. Right. It was the first time I did anything illegal. I got the mugshot because of you. Anyway, but it was like so important for us to be there to hear his music. And our story has kind of continued in odd ways over the years. That's another program. But I just wanted to tell you that I love him, actually. Here he is.
Thank you so much. It's wonderful to be here. Listen to Nora, I had never met her before tonight, and it's funny, it's like I'd known her all of it. It was a very interesting, and she lives in Germany part of the year, and I lived like down the tracks, like an hour and a half away from her in the Netherlands. So this whole thing started rolling, then hearing her show was phenomenal. And I remember a story one time they told me about Woody, and they bought a train set for Arlo. An electric train set, and they bought it, and they were going to take it up to you, and they were up at the, with Gordon Sis, and they set the train set up, and they just kept playing with it, and they never took it to the. and then another story about Woody and Cisco Houston. They were going to a bar down in Midtown, and they saw Pete Seeger coming, and they ran the other way and ran into an alley. It's like, I guess Pete Seeger's pretty straight. Wow.
Oh, I see in your prison your chains, how they clamor, how they clang. Like fingers reaching through the darkness, gripping on your bars and veins. I would only like to see you. That is all and nothing more. But I will go unbounded, looking outside of your door. Go unbounded, outside of your door.